Hello, sir. Give me your name, please.
Trey Cox.
All right, Trey. And have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed?
Yes, sir.
How do you know you received the Holy Ghost?
Evidence of speaking in other tongues.
Wow. Well, so if you didn't speak in tongues, you're saying you wouldn't have the Holy Ghost?
No.
So when people say they do have the Holy Ghost, but tongues is nowhere in the answer, are you saying that they don't have it?
Yes.
Well, Trey, I agree with you. According to the Bible, they don't have it. But please, share your testimony with us.
I was raised in a Pentecostal house, or family, I should say. My uncle and my grandma and pretty much everybody in my family is Pentecostal. And being raised that way, I've always been around a church, never really been in depth to a service, to preaching and things like that until I turned about 12 or 13, and I actually started listening and paying attention as to what was going on. And then February 13th, 2012, yeah, so I was a freshman, 2012, I was in Litchfield, Illinois, I didn't live in Litchfield, I lived in Springfield, but we went to church in Litchfield. And there was altar call service in the church that I was going to, and I went down there, you know, with my youth group.
So the whole group, you went down with the whole group? Or?
Yeah, that was a common thing in the church for everyone to go down there and pray, and just a congregational type of worship at the end of a sermon.
Okay.
And we would, usually, I was one of those people that kind of just went down there and kind of wall watched, and I was a space filler, really, standing and not really going through the motions, of a church kid.
Gotcha.
And I got around with some of my friends, and we were praying, and I started feeling kind of heavy, burdens started weighing down kind of hard in my head.
Wow.
And one of my friends was talking to me, and he was just saying stuff that was hitting me right in the heart. And they had me just lifting my hands up and talking to God. And then before I knew it, I was just crying and just yelling out, top of my lungs at the Lord.
Wow.
And then after...
So your hands are up, the tears are coming down, you're shouting out to the top of your lungs to the Lord. Wow. And what were you feeling?
I started, once I finally kind of just like let go of it all and stopped, because I think my problem was that a problem with a lot of people is when people pray, they're so worried about how they look.
Oh, wow.
At the altar, they don't want to look crazy, they don't want to look wild, they don't want to stand out.
Yeah.
And I think once I just stopped caring, it kind of just, I felt a lot better. Felt like I didn't have anybody to impress. I just wanted to have a conversation with God.
Yeah.
And I think that's kind of what walked me, or led me into getting the Holy Ghost.
Okay, so you're still at the altar now, you done let it go, you're not caring what you look like, but you're still shouting out, and is that when the tongues begin to flow?
Yeah, about, I've been talking and screaming for about 5 minutes, and then just words start to pour out of my mouth, it sounded like a completely different language. It was like, I didn't have control of my speech anymore.
Wow.
And it was just kind of flowing like I was having a full-blown conversation with someone in a whole other language.
Wow. So you weren't mimicking the man in front of you. You wasn't making this up. This just come out.
Yeah.
Wow. So your tongue was trying to do one thing, but your tongue was, but something else was coming out different.
Yeah, it was in my head. I was trying to figure out what I was saying, but my mouth just wanted to keep talking.
Wow. Wow. So what else happened?
I spoke in tongues for about 5 minutes, and then once I finally stopped, I was still crying, and my pastor at the time had asked me when the service had slowed down, everybody was still standing up front, and he got kind of quiet, and he asked me over the pulpit, did I feel like I received the gift of the Holy Ghost, and I said yes.
Wow. So,
it was my uncle that had baptized me. And he was just going over how I had grown spiritually over the course of the years. And then once he got to the actual baptism, he said, Trey, I baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. And then dunked me out of the water.
Well, so where is that found at in the Bible if someone's trying to check this out?
In Acts 2:38, it says, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Wow, so when it says, you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, does it mean that you're going to receive the Holy Ghost right now? Or is it just promised that you still receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, sir?
It's a promise, it's a covenant with you, saying it's available to you.
Gotcha. So you may receive it instantly, you might receive it before the baptism like you, and then again it might be another 2 years before you receive it. Mm-hmm. But shall would be a future tense word, correct?
Yes. Correct.
Okay. We say all this because the Bible does show that when you receive the Holy Spirit, as in Acts chapter 10, verse 44 through 48, Acts chapter 19, verses 2, 1 through 6, Acts chapter 2, verse 1 through 4, the Bible shows specifically that when they received the Holy Ghost, they spake with tongues. Also, the scripture shows in Acts chapter 8, the story of Philip and the sorcerer Simon in the town of Samaria. The Bible shows that when Philip baptized them, they did not receive the Holy Ghost. But the question was, how did Philip, who did the baptizing, who was one of the apostles, how did Philip know that they did not receive the Holy Ghost? I mean, then scripture shows that Philip sends for Peter and John because his words were, they've repented in Samaria, they've received the word of God, but they have not received the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost has not yet fallen. So the question is, how did they not know, or how did they know the Holy Ghost hadn't fallen? I say that because in today's church now, everyone tends to have the Holy Ghost. But would the original apostles thought that you had the Holy Ghost? Or were they looking for some particular form of evidence? The answer is they were looking for a particular form of evidence. And if you didn't receive that evidence, they declared you as not having the Holy Ghost. All of this is meant for encouragement to where you will keep seeking, keep seeking. Romans chapter 8, verse 9, 10, and 11. Speak on, without the Spirit of Jesus Christ, you're none of His. And without the Spirit that raised Christ from the dead, you will not be resurrected, which means it's mandatory to receive the Holy Spirit. Trey, thank you so much for your testimony. Is there any last words you'd like to say before you move on?
Don't procrastinate.
Good words. Good words. Don't procrastinate. Awesome. Respond back to Trey through Facebook or what have you, and he'd be glad to tell you about a church that baptizes in Jesus' name where you can get the Holy Ghost, and you'll get the privilege of watching Trey slap them drums every Sunday morning. The man is talented. Thank you, Trey.